Hi, my name is Melanie, and I am your IVF nurse. Today's topic is going to be about embryo transfers, and this can refer to either fresh or frozen. I'm not going to talk much about the details of embryo grading if you're doing a fresh or frozen transfer, but more so from the perspective of what you can expect as a patient on your transfer day. So what's going to happen is when you've gotten your date and time for your transfer from the embryology or the nurses, what will happen is you'll show up. In some clinics, you'll check in and you will just be taken to the back, and then in other clinics, you may meet with a nurse first, and then they'll go through all your instructions with you as to your post-embryo transfer, what to expect, what you can do, can't do, all of those things. So at some point, either before or after your embryo transfer, they're going to give you your instructions and top you up with any progesterone supplementation that you may need, or if you're taking estrace or anything like that for medicated frozen embryo transfers, then they would make sure that you've got everything you need to get you through until the big test date. Now, what's your important thing in all of this is to show up with a full bladder. So the instructions will be that you'll have to drink or finish drinking at least 1 liter of water an hour before your procedure time. Now, when you get to the clinic, if you're burstingly full, then you can always speak to someone and see if you can release a little bit. However, you do want to bring something to drink in the event you need to top up if you're not full enough or if you've peed too much to kind of relieve yourself, and then you've got to drink a little bit more. Now, once you're full and the ultrasound technician gives the go-ahead, the doctor usually walks in, and then the doctor may say a few words to you about the embryo quality, what's being transferred that day. The embryo transfer itself literally takes maybe a few minutes to do, if that. So what happens is that the doctor will put a speculum in the vagina, and if you've been doing a medicated transfer, they usually recommend that you don't do the progesterone suppositories or anything intravaginally just prior to the transfer, so your morning dose, just because the doctor's got to clean out all of that stuff in order to do the embryo transfer. Now, depending on your time, they may say, if you've got an early afternoon appointment, they may say to you, yes, do your morning meds if you're doing them intravaginally, and you know, don't worry about it because the doctor, like I said, will clean it out just prior to the transfer. So when they're cleaning out inside the vagina prior to the transfer, it may feel a little bit cool and wet. It may be a little bit uncomfortable because your bladder will be full and you'll have a speculum there that will be pressing, and then you've got usually the ultrasound technician pressing on your bladder. So that's usually the most uncomfortable thing about an embryo transfer. Now, once everything's all cleaned up inside, the doctor is going to put in a kind of like an outer catheter into the cervical os, which is going to be then measured to where it needs to be placed in the uterus. And then once that's all set, they will give the okay to the embryology to load the embryo or embryos into the inner catheter, which is what is going to house the embryo or embryos in the interim until it's passed. So once the embryos are loaded into the catheter, the embryologist will pass that to the doctor and also identify the patient. And just as a key point, identification of the patient is always done prior to the procedure, as well as when the embryos are being handed to the doctor to be inserted. Green. Now, once the embryologist has passed the catheter with the embryo in to the doctor's hand, that is usually like the last check where the embryologist will say these embryo or embryos are for patient so-and-so, and they'll give the identifying name, and then from there the doctor places the catheter into the outer catheter, and then this is done under ultrasound guidance, so you'll be able to see where the catheter is going and exactly where they have measured out to deposit the embryo. So then the doctor will notify you to look for a white flash, which is the media that is surrounding or housing the embryo or embryos in the transfer. And what will happen is that once that flash is seen, the doctor will then slowly remove the inner catheter, which had the embryo or embryos in it, pass that back to the embryologist, who will then examine the catheter, do a flushing of the catheter to ensure that the embryo was not stuck there, and then they will slowly remove the outer catheter, and then at that point the embryologist will do the same thing and notify all clear, and then from there the doctor will remove the speculum. Usually the doctor may recommend waiting a few minutes before getting off the exam table, or sometimes they're saying, okay, up to the bathroom and you can go pee. Some people are really superstitious about getting up, because maybe with a previous transfer they got up too soon, or they think they got up too soon and maybe it didn't work. You are able to pee. You cannot pee out the embryo or embryos. You can't cough them out, sneeze them out, or anything like that. They are placed in the uterus, safe and sound. And then usually, depending on the facility, sometimes the nurses will want to keep you about 30 minutes after, and that's where they will review any instructions for your post-transfer, and they also confirm the test date with you when you're going back. And then with other facilities where you get your instructions prior to transfer, the doctor may discharge you as soon as the transfer is done once you've peed, and then you're into the 2-week wait, where you're hopefully taking it as easy as possible. So things like no heavy lifting, no sex, no exercise, nothing that overexerts you. You're not gonna, you know, decide to go home and rearrange your furniture. You're also not going to go shopping and carry all the bags. That's something your partner can do, or your friend who's with you doing those things. Usually you wanna go home and have a few lazy days where you're just relaxing and taking it easy as possible, just so that you're not doing anything that, in the event you're not successful with your transfer, that you're thinking, oh, is it because I did this? So you do want to listen to the nurses and the doctors about your post-transfer instructions, and then showing up for your blood test for your pregnancy as directed, even if you should have some spotting or bleeding. Now, if this should happen, what I recommend is that you do reach out to the clinic and they'll be able to advise you. We have seen it in cases where people will do urine tests and it comes back negative, and patients come in and they're all discouraged, and then they do the blood test and it comes back positive. So I'm not the biggest fan of home urine tests for pregnancy. Blood tests are always most accurate. So in the event you're getting negative tests, don't let that totally discourage you. You will still need to do your blood test, because as I mentioned, it is something that we've seen where people have brought in the negative tests and shown them to me and their beta comes back positive. So not that that is always the case, but until you're doing the blood test, it's the best thing to wait and see. Feel free to check out my website, www.yourivfnurse.com. Please feel free to send me an email at yourivfnurse@gmail.com. Thanks for watching.